shopping in a Japanese supermarket.
Yay!
Supermarkets are quite different because food in Japan is different. For an example, these bell peppers are tiny compared to what I'm used to. These eggplants are also quite small in comparison to what I'm used to. Then on the other hand, carrots in this country, for some reason, are huge. I have no idea why there is a size difference between vegetables from country to country. And also, like, a price difference. Huge price difference from country to country. I did a little survey today. Onions from a department store are this much. Organic onions from a department store are this much. Onions at the supermarket are this much. So as you can see, there's quite a variety of prices in the different places I went to. Another huge difference is the cuts of meat. You see, you know how there's that picture of the cow with all the lines on it that demarcate which parts are which bits? Those lines are not actually on the cow. Those lines are made up by people, and in every country they're different. So actually, like a T-bone or a ribeye or, you know, any porterhouse or any type of term you might use in the U.S. is probably a U.S.-specific term, although, like, many of those cuts, like, for example, steak cuts are universal because, you know, they're delicious that way. There's other cuts of meat. So, like, in a Japanese meat section, you have a hard time finding similar things to what you'd expect back home. I wanted to buy a chicken, right, which could be a fairly simple thing to find, you would think. But the reality is I've been to 5 supermarkets and not been able to find a chicken. They just do not sell the chicken. What they do sell is chicken bits. I guess I could staple them together and make one big chicken and then roast it. It's not quite the same thing. The reason is all things are cut down to smaller sizes, but people mostly cook stir-fry or yakiniku, which is like kind of grilled meat, or yakitori, smaller bits of meat, reign supreme in Tokyo, because basically nobody roasts large hunks of meat except Europeans. And every now and then I want to do that, so there's other places you can go to get large hunks of meat, obviously. that the seafood section is going to be a lot larger than the seafood section in your typical supermarket back home. Also, there's sections here that we wouldn't even imagine having back home. For example, the tofu section. I'm pretty certain where you're from, there's not a tofu section of the department of the supermarket. And there's all these things like konnyaku, which is interesting, and natto, which is disgusting, and kimchi section, and pickles. Japanese and Chinese style pickles. There's any number of different things you'd find here. It's all seaweed right here, folks. This is, of course, the noodle section. Udon, soba, ramen, any kind of noodle you could possibly want. So I've made many mistakes in my time here. The most notable one was when I tried to buy salt and purchase this, which looks to the discerning eye like a panda head filled with salt. However, this, in fact, is salt. They look nearly the same. However, what I first purchased mistakenly was, in fact, a bottle of MSG, and was liberally putting it on all of my food and thinking, wow, this salt sucks. I really should use more. I went through like half a bottle, I think, on like one plate of spaghetti, and just gave up. So like, this is the shittiest salt ever. And had like crazy sweaty nightmares that night. Because it's not easy when you don't know the language yet to go shopping. Now I've fully mastered ingredients. So I've got a little bit better, but still, you gotta check. Like when I first got here, you know, I would just look at the package and say, oh, look, there's a chicken on it. This must be chicken. But now that I can read the language, I spent forever going, kara soup. You know, it's chicken soup stock. But, yeah, originally I would have just used the picture as a guide. Now, you actually have to try and read stuff. Less fun. So this little adventure is to go to a place called Niku no Hanamasa. It's a meat wholesaler. And the reason I am bothering and mentioning it to you, the gaijin crowd, is because if you are ever looking for a large or whole animal, this is about the only place you can go that can get it for you. They often carry like whole chickens or ribs, cuts of meat that, you know, sometimes supermarkets don't stock, because this place is actually a restaurant supplier. And today I'm going to buy a huge hunk of pork, which I'm going to slow cook in an electric toaster. You do what you can with what you have, huh? Now this is a piece of meat. Oh, those are some ribs. Meat. Large frozen blocks of meat. They even have shit like lamb here, which is very hard to find in Japan. Lots of other things might not have ease finding, like brain and stomach and... Oh, look. Testicles. Wow. A
think I'll pass.
Generally speaking, everything here is in bulk, and as a result, it's cheaper. So you can buy like huge bags or boxes of whatever you need. It's like a Costco in a way, but much smaller.
Two little chickens and a big hunk of pork.
I'm a very happy man right now. Very happy man.
For an expat living in a foreign country, your sanity is often saved by import shops, places that contain things from another world. Yamaya is my personal favorite, and though it's actually really a liquor discount store, they have an enormous selection of imported foodstuffs from all over the world. Things that, basically from whatever corner of the planet you come from, you might recognize and say, oh my god, they have this here? It's an incredibly useful shop, and I highly suggest checking it out. While you definitely can survive in Japan doing only what the locals do and eating only what the locals eat, I think even if only for sentimental reasons you want to get a thing of couscous or a shape of pasta you wouldn't normally find, baked beans, loopy nut knockoff cereal, there's any number of things that you really start to crave when you live in a foreign country. Now, it is also usually expensive. I will put on the side in the information section information about a number of different shops that specialize in foreign and imported goods. One, for example, is Seijo Ishii, which is a very expensive shop dealing with select brand things. Other useful stores to check out are Kaldi Coffee Farm, the American Pharmacy, even Sony Plaza. There's also a Costco now in Japan, but that I'll save for another video.
Japanese bacon sucks. This is the average little mini half bacon they pass off as bacon. I hate it. Never cooks right.
Run! Run!